Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Lost in Time. Well, we found the coordinates for the Isle of San Cristobal because this very lousy and clumsy and obnoxious and I still want to shoot him. Melkior, no, I don't want to shoot him. He lost his logbook again and so we had to find the coordinates, which we did. And they were on this label, so let's give it to him and he can take care of the rest. Let's go for it.
The island's coordinates are on this piece of paper. Great. Now we can go there.
Yeah.
Good. I'll take care of Yoruba.
Yep.
I'm going to set my time pass. Are you ready? Let's go.
Whoa.
Darlies, how are you feeling? Is everything all right?
Yes, it's better than the first time. Ah, Yoruba is regaining consciousness. He will need care.
Yoruba, you must help us now. Tell us about Velvet and Jarlath.
The master, Jarlath, Velvet's husband, was always absent. Then Velvet turned her smiling eyes toward me and my heart forgot its troubles. Out of our love, Maximin was born. Jarlath knew that he was not his child, but even so, he gave him his name, De La Prunelière.
Darlies, go and look over there. I understand everything. Your resemblance to Velvet, the child, can't you see?
How? No, wait! You mean that Yoruba is my father?
What?
Oh, that's incredible!
Yoruba, tell me, how does one see Velvet discreetly?
You must go and see Delia. Velvet often consults her. She lives close to Makandal, the healer. And if you go to the property, ask for Serapion. He will help you if you say that I sent you. He knows everything that is happening on the island.
A candle? A healer? Okay, I will tell him to come and heal you. Afterwards, I'll go and see Velvet and Serapion.
What do you mean you will go? I am the one who's supposed to go. You must stay here with Yoruba.
Absolutely not. I'm the one who's supposed to take care of it.
It's my life, isn't it? And can you see me staying here on the beach, alone with a slave?
Hey,
you can go and get
prejudice?
This candle,
he's
and then
father.
We'll see. We need to stay in touch. Take this holocomb.
Yes,
it works with solar power.
And that's why they turned pink. Okay, great. We have a holocomb. What else do we have in our inventory? The corkscrew and the parrot and the flag. Okay. And still the small pipe. Can we talk to you?
Well, Doralice, are you going?
Yes, in a minute. And can we talk to our ancestor? No. Well, this is just a great confusion, isn't it? Let's go. Oops, I didn't want to go there. Ah. Oops, what's that? Wow. What in the world was that? The man has disappeared through this passage. An urn. Put here all your gifts, and if your heart is pure, the great Macandal will grant your wishes. Well, I guess not an inscription. Ask all women to go away. Is Macandal afraid of women? Or maybe he just likes men? We don't know. Okay, and there is a kid. Let's talk. Is there anything else? No. There is a coconut. And there. Let's talk to the kid.
What are you doing there, little man? Don't be afraid. I just want to talk. My name is Amilcar. I am hiding in order to follow Makandal, the healer. He is my father, but he doesn't want me. Makandal. Perfect. I must see him. I need him. Do you know where he lives? Of course, but I don't know what to do. My baby Maniku has fallen into the waterfall. He no longer has a mother. Poor darling. Without a mother and left alone by the father. Okay, I'll take care of your friend. Then you will help me.
Now hopefully, huh? All right, so that Matiku, whatever kind of animal it is, has fallen into the waterfall and is probably cold. So let's see, what do we have? The old flag. Well, I think we can give it away.
Let's wrap him with this.
Yeah.
It'll help him get warm. Don't worry, he won't get pneumonia.
Okay. And maybe we should feed him to... Well, what's better than a fresh coconut? It just fell from the tree, perfectly ripe. So there should be cocoa milk in there. And let's screw a hole. Yes, that works. Great, and since we still have our small pipe, I'll drink some of the stuff. Slurp, slurp. Okay. Now let's give that to the...
This is
whatever.
A mini bottle for a mini
Matiku.
Baby.
Yeah.
I'll leave you the bottle and a way to open it so you can feed him.
Good.
Thank you, miss. My father's parrot is in the cage that you have. It knows me. I'd like to have it.
Uh-huh.
Gallipo. McCandle's parrot. Then Captain Philibert and McCandle must know each other. I am willing to give you Gallipo, but don't forget your promise. Show me how to go to McCandle. He first presses on the stones in this order, then he pronounces the word Majumbe and continues. Try
okay,
it.
Okay, that can't be all that difficult if we have the Majumbe on our cursor. Let's do that.
Okay. I pronounce the word Majumbe. Nothing happens. Amilcar, are you sure of it? It doesn't work for me, but I swear that McCandle is able to make it work by doing what I say.
Okay, if we can't do it because we're a woman and he's a kid and has a high voice, we still have the parrot. Yeah, okay, we don't want to touch him, no, but maybe that works.
Let's see if Gallipo is luckier than I am. This McCandle is well protected, mainly against women. Only this parrot could say it with its master's voice.
Well, then his master has the most annoying voice.
Here is Gallipo. Your father should have given it to you rather than to the captain. But I keep the cage because it has a double bottom. Say, could you get the key that is attached to Gallipo's leg? Get this, miss. Goodbye. Thanks for your help, Amilcar. Now I will go and see my father.
Okay, what do we have here? What's in our inventory? A flat key and an empty cage. That's great. But let's first knock on the door. And see... And what mood he
First,
is.
How did you get here? Second,
secret.
Who are you? And finally, what do you want?
I have seen your parrot, Gallipo. My name is Doralis, and I bring you a gift.
Forget immediately the path that led you here, or bad luck will be yours.
Yeah, yeah.
Flip. Is it a large gift?
It is rather valuable.
Okay, let's see. Ah, there is a slot in the door. Put your gift in there.
Okay, we'll do that. But first, what gift? Well, maybe we should use the key on the cage. And there are golden pieces. And I guess, goodbye money again. I'm sorry. Oh, yeah. No,
are you
I did
sent
it.
By the spirit okay. of good or by the spirit of evil?
Neither one. I simply need your skills.
Because I am in a good mood, and since you have paid for the consultation, I will give you 3 minutes.
You know Yoruba, don't you? He is wounded. He needs your help.
The sorcerer who stole all my customers, the one who lives in the Rushford plantation, little Bikki's friend.
Yes, I am here to tell him to leave the island. I am a relative of Madame Velvet.
Ah, if you order him to leave the island, then we can do something. Right, and I must fix a certain Delia who keeps getting after me like a mad dog. To protect myself, I need a piece of clothing. Find it and bring it to me. You won't regret it.
Okay, the game seems to be scrambled there, but it doesn't really matter. Okay, we're in front of Delia's cabin, and I'm going to finish this part here and make the next one a bit longer and the final episode too. So join me for the final episode next time. Stay tuned. Bye-bye.